everybody. My name's Alan. On behalf of, my co-host is not here tonight, and I'll tell you why in a minute, but on behalf of the crew of the show, I'd like to welcome you to another. It's a very wonderful and powerful show we have tonight. We have a really interesting guest who's going to do healings and healings on people here, healings for people at home. She's going to just give you a lot of information that I'm sure will be of great value to everyone. And also I'd like to wish Wistancia well. She was visiting her family in Houston, Texas, and got an ear infection, and they recommended that she not fly back. So she, you know, sends her regards and, you know, says she would have loved to have been on the show, especially tonight, but she won't be able to make it. So I'm going to have to be the solo host tonight, so we'll see how that goes. So we hope Wistancia will feel better and be back with us next week. Also, I guess you know that the show is on now at a different time at 9:30. It used to be on the first, 11 weeks, it was on from 9 to 10 on Thursdays as the original time, but now it's on from 9:30 to 10:30. And the repeat show, if you want to tape it or see it again or tell other people, is noon on Monday. So the show will be shown again noon on Monday, and our regular time is 9:30 on Thursdays. So again, we have an extremely powerful show, and we'd like to get right to it. And normally at this time, we have Wistancia lead us in an invocation, but since I don't know really how to do an invocation in that way, so I'll just try to lead everyone into silence with a short meditation. And we'll have a clip. We have some wonderful clips that people have called in and recommended. And it should be a very wonderful show tonight. Actually, people tell me I always pick one word a show and use it 1,000 times. It was exciting at the beginning, then it was powerful. And I think this show is going to be wonderful. So we'll see. Hopefully it will be a wonderful show. I'll lead everybody in a short meditation. So just go to the place, the quietest place inside yourself, the silence. Try to set in there, try to experience it, and try to watch the show from that place. Try to experience this show from that place, because our guest Anamika wants you to come from that place, will encourage you to come from that place, and hopefully if you're not there, we'll lead you there. So follow me inside and just do it. Okay, so now we have a clip, and we did the clip because we picked this clip specially because it's Wistancia's favorite clip, and we thought that since she wasn't going to be here tonight, it's an angel clip, and we know how she likes to call the angels in and experience the angels. So as soon as the clip is queued up, we'll see it. It's a very beautiful clip. There are still images of the clips, and it should be ready to go, and here it comes. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Stance, You Get Better, and we know that that's your favorite clip. Well, with me on the set is Anamika, who's a spiritual teacher and a healer. And I went to a workshop with her once, and it was very powerful, and I hope you get a feeling for it tonight. So, good evening.
Hi, Alan.
So, the first question I'd like to ask, I think, is in a lot of people's minds, is how would you define what a spiritual teacher is?
That's a very good question, because I've gone through a whole evolution about how to call myself. And I began by thinking, I began as a psychotherapist and moved through the phase of calling myself a healer. And then I came to realize that I couldn't even go with that, because the process of healing itself is very associated with the medical model, where someone is broken and they come to be fixed. And I don't see it that way. I see that I'm much more a guide for the process of awakening. And we're in a time now that is the most exciting time on the planet ever, where we're being given the opportunity to actually go through the doorway into our own inner divinity, which is called the process of waking up or awakening. And it's much more
like... You mean
like,
other people at other times have had that opportunity, but you mean on a wide scale, more and more people as a planet, in a sense?
That's right. The entire planet right now is shifting dimension. And is being taken through doorway after doorway after doorway, portal after portal, which is an unprecedented time. It's extremely exciting. And in other times, individuals were able to go through those doorways. But somebody in olden times who would be called a saint, already many people on this planet are way beyond the level of evolution that was a saint in olden times, which shows you that it's a very, very steep climb, but what's occurring right now is that spirit has drawn extremely close to the planet and is actually surrounding the entire planet with so much energy that we're being boosted, we're actually being leveraged to go through the doorway.
Is there any reason for that? I mean, in particular, this time is a...
Yes, there is a reason, which is that it's the time now for the Earth to go through that.
It's just meant to happen.
It's the time for us to go into the next dimension. The old dimension is one of fear, it's one of greed, it's one of anxiety. It's one where people just are living a life of terrible struggle, of hardship, of deprivation. And the new dimension, which some people call the fourth, some people call the fifth, it doesn't matter what language you use, is a dimension of love and cooperation, harmony, peace, where there'll be abundance for everyone. And the abundance already exists, but we're not able to draw it in until we embrace that consciousness that comes from love. So we're in that time now of being given the opportunity. So my work is actually as a guide for people to go through those steps. And what I do when I work with people on an individual basis is identify with them in their energy field or their aura or their level of consciousness or the frequency bands in which they live. I help them see where their consciousness or their awareness is not yet of the love that they want and where it is of that love. And what I actually do is assist them to shift those frequencies that are not yet of the highest love that they're looking to embrace. And that's the process of awakening. So it's really not going somewhere, but it's waking up to who you already are inside yourself.
So through your life and your destiny, you've been allowed to go through some of those portals so you can help others.
That's right.
Go through them.
Yes, and it's a never-ending process. I used to think, and I think all of us have been brought up this way, I used to think that enlightenment or evolution was that you go on some mountaintop somewhere, you end up in some state of permanent eternal bliss on some, you know, some mountaintop.
Some TV talk show usually.
There you go. And and the actual process is one of learning. For most of us, it's learning to be a human being in our body, fully here, present, alive on this planet, and also in our divinity, which means that we come to a state of being so entwined with source, spirit, love, whatever words you want to use for it, that we come to a state of grace. And that state of grace is really a state of acceptance of all of who we are, which includes the darkness. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of the spiritual movement even has, in the attempt to reach for the light, has ignored the darkness or even rejected it. Mm-hmm. And really what the entire situation is about, the situation of waking up to who we are, is being able to own and admit very, very honestly what that darkness is within us and what the light is, to embrace our gifts fully and also to embrace the darkness as an enormous opportunity to go through the next gateway. So once we are not afraid of the darkness within us and can actually...
To live on this planet and in a physical body means you carry darkness with you? There's no alternative at this point?
Not at this point. Perhaps several hundred years from now, when the planet has fully made the shift, we'll be able to live here in human form with no darkness. But right now, the very process
By this weekend, we're not...
No, not by this weekend, and probably not by 50 years from now, and not within our lifetime. Uh-huh. So just by virtue of the fact of being here and being alive, it means that we need to accept that darkness as the next doorway or the next portal into the light. And the truth is, if we think about God as all that is and everything, that also includes the darkness. It includes the light and the darkness. And the problem with the darkness has really been that we're afraid of it, and we end up judging ourselves for having it instead of seeing it as a very profound opportunity.
How would you like define the darkness then? How does darkness manifest for you? It's fear and greed.
Fear, jealousy, anger, anxiety, envy, sloth.
The crew in the booth, they love those things. Not like you. So those are the things that we have to recognize a part of what a human being is at this point.
Yes, it's part of what we've embraced at just being here. And as we learn to accept that and ask for help for those things to be lifted, they actually do get better and better and better. But my experience has been, well, I used to have a much more, I would call it a Pollyanna approach, where I thought, well, everything that was within me that was dark, I could get rid of it. I could heal it all, and that would be the end
right.
of it. And what I've actually come to find is that much of it does lift. And what I've found is that one can enter a state of tremendous joy, tremendous peace, tremendous ease, where you're just really in love for no reason. Mm-hmm. But even with that, there's left sprinkled a few little places that just
remind you.
So you think
in a human body that there are, everyone's going to have a cross to bear in some way, shape, or form?
Well, I would phrase it, yes, in a way you can say it that way, or you could say that everyone is given a quantity of something to transmute, because the darkness that we're actually given
transmute meaning
into more light,
oh.
that the darkness or the fears that we're given, when we use them and when we appreciate them and look upon them with gratitude, that very stuff becomes the substance that can get transmuted into more joy and into more light, so that it doesn't have to be something that we bear. It doesn't have to be a burden. And what ends up happening is that we lose the charge, or we lose the fear about our fear. You know, we lose the fear of our greed or the fear of our jealousy, and we come to just be able to admit, you know, that's how I am sometimes. I just get that way.
Yeah, I know, but when it manifests, I mean, you're not always able to, like, be separate from it. So then you're identifying with it, and then it causes pain. Wouldn't you say that?
When it does that, yes, it can do that. And the more you're able to own that pain, and also when you hurt somebody out of your own fears or out of your greed, then you apologize to the person and you make amends where you can. But the more you do that process, the less afraid you become of that. And then at that point, you actually can make friends with it. It's a strange process that I never actually thought was possible till I found that started happening in my life, where I began to see that the worst fears I had in my life were ones that, as I was able to make friends with them and just embrace them, I wasn't afraid of them anymore. And they became a portal or gateway through into more love.
Which ones would you say that at this point either you haven't made quite, they're not your best friend yet, or you, like, say, you're not conscious of yet? Are there those that you would say are still crosses that you're dealing with?
Well, what I would say is this very last period of time has been a profoundly intense one for me, where I moved to Santa Barbara, and I had lived in Massachusetts, where I had started a community, and then I had also gone to Florida, where I had started communities all over Florida. And as I moved to Santa Barbara, I was placed on a mountaintop, literally, in a beautiful, beautiful setting overlooking the ocean. And I didn't know anybody here when I moved here, but I was very strongly guided to come and to start the work here. And I needed to face some of the places in me that I hadn't yet been totally honest about. And my integrity had been that I want to be 100% self-responsible, which meant I wanted to be able to face and admit everything, all of my motivations, all of the ones that were coming out of a self-centered place and were not from an altruistic perspective. And I got a chance to face them very, very deeply by sitting in my cabin and just being alone for almost 2 months, and every day watching, just facing every motivation that came up that wasn't an altruistic one, that wasn't of the highest, that wasn't about the purpose of service. And I'm very clear that I came here to serve. You know, it's been a very, very powerful mission in my life, where I remember from the incarnation right before this one, I had been in the Holocaust. and was a boy, a young boy, about 15 years old, and the Nazis came to the door. And I had come to that life with the purpose of defeating the darkness, which was the Holocaust, and I got defeated instead. And when the Nazis came to the door, I attempted to protect my family by lying and saying to the Nazis, nobody's home, and I attempted to protect the family, and they actually didn't believe me. They dragged me, and they...
Yeah, with Nazis were not good believers.
They could tell when you were...
Right.
Right. It wasn't. No. So they actually took a club and clubbed me to death, breaking my skull and, you know, really doing tremendous physical damage. And as I left my body, I looked down, and I could see that they invaded the house and grabbed my family and actually killed them as well. And I was so bereft about this and so devastated because I'd come here to serve.
Well, how do we come and have this destiny and in a sense, the way you're describing it, although I don't know if I would describe it, that we fail? How does that work?
Well, my intention had been...
I don't understand anything.
My intention in that life had been to actually serve, right, and to help defeat the forces of darkness.
Right.
And I myself got defeated, so I felt like it. I had failed. It wasn't actually a failure, but I had, right, felt so strongly that I had failed that in between lives you go into Source, and I went to God and said, I want to come back and try it again. I have to do something
but
different.
But not with the Nazis.
No, not in this day and age.
You don't want to go to Bosnia.
No, not really. But so what happened in this time is that I came back and with the intention to serve, with the intention to bring light to the planet, and I was given a gift that I find a very, very beautiful gift, which is called Saqqara. It's a temple of healing, and what occurs is that people come into the temple, and the gift that I've been given in this life is the ability to invoke very, very strong energies, which create a spontaneous shift in people's awareness when they come into the temple.
The temple is not a physical place,
it's a
space place.
Yes, it's made up of energy. It's made up of very large geometric forms that come into the room. It's made up of a pyramid, it's made up of a crystalline column which descends and comes into the room. It has the ascended masters coming in, it has all of the archangels, and people's own personal spirit guides come, as well as my guides and all of the masters who've been on the planet. And they come for the purpose of helping people to wake up to who they are. So what occurs is that as people enter the temple, they experience a spontaneous shift in consciousness where they come more into the love that they really are. And the darkness or the wounding that they have grown up with in this life, that comes from this life and other lives, actually gets pulled off.
So it almost like changes the momentum of a human life.
It does. It changes the cellular frequency. It changes the frequency of their entire
body. Does it hold?
Body. Yes, it does. And what happens is that whatever the awakening is that occurs holds at that time, and then the next thing is that they have to integrate that and use it in their lives, and they'll see the change very, very dramatically. Then they come back whenever they're ready to. They come back into the temple of healing and they go through the next awakening. And so it's a process of like a flower that continues to unfold until it reveals the most beautiful essence inside, and that essence is our divinity. It's our divine essence. It's love. It's unconditional love. And so the gift that I've been given is the ability to invoke these energies and to travel around the planet, assisting people to awaken to who they are. And in that context, great healings often happen, but I don't view it from the perspective of I am going in there to heal someone. I had to get very clear that it's not me who does the healing, and it's not even me who does the energy. It's the energy of Source and all of the masters who come, and the gift I've been given is the ability to invoke that energy.
So you're a vehicle for that, right, being of use on this planet at this time.
Right. And
you can do your service.
That's my service, and that's my gift to humanity, and that was God's gift to me. And each, right, one of us is given an extremely beautiful gift. They're all different, but they're all equally valuable and powerful. And the gift that Saqqara is that it helps people awaken to what their unique gift is.
And how did this name Saqqara get to be or come around to?
Yeah. Well, I was part of the soul of Isis, the high priestess, back in Egyptian times, and had done a lot of healing there. And what happened in this life, in this incarnation, was that I was working on somebody who had a brain tumor. And what I was discussing with him, he came for healing, what he thought was healing. He, right, came saying, please get rid of my brain tumor. This is what I want.
I can see how that would be some concern to him at that point.
Yeah. And we did the usual things, like cleared the chemotherapy out of his aura. We cleared his energy field. We got rid of the headache that had been there for 5 months. And he thought that this was the healing, until what he actually had to learn was that the healing was about love. Meaning, I had to say to him, look, is what you want to get rid of your brain tumor, you know, which the answer, of course, was yes, but...
if you could, with everything else you're
doing. Right, with everything else, that part's fine. But I said to him, you know, what actually occurs when you die, whether it's from this brain tumor or from something else, when you die and you go into source or go into the light, the main question that you'll be asked is, how deeply have you loved? Have you spent this lifetime loving? Really, really deeply loving. And when you go, that's all that matters. You know, you go with empty pockets. You can't take anything with you except that love, that joy. That's all that you can take. And the feeling, the wonderful feeling that you get from having spread the love and shared that love with other people. So just as I was discussing this with him, that it was really about loving and it wasn't about the eradication of the tumor, although that's a wonderful thing also.
Right.
What happened is that I heard a voice.
If you're living your life without a tumor and it's miserable, what difference does it make?
That's right. And often the illness becomes the entree or the vehicle, or people, when they get ill, it becomes their great teacher.
It breaks them down.
It softens them up. That's right, to a place where they start to ask for help, and they start to say, okay, there must be more to life than this. This is, I'm ill, I'm suffering, I'm struggling, you know, help. And as soon as they say help from their heart, something begins to happen.
Right.
And what occurred that day when I was working with this particular man was that I heard a voice very, very clearly say, Saqqara, Temple of Healing, in thy presence be I whole. And then the voice stopped. And the feeling that occurred was so profound. It just went through me that, oh my God, this is what I've been looking for my whole life. You know, I always knew.
Right away, there was just like an instant, like
instant,
meshing that this,
yes.
This is really me in a way.
Yes, it felt like, and I didn't even understand fully what it was, and I still don't understand fully the profundity of what this is all about.
Right.
But what I got was that there was something so profound that I gave up my entire life as I had known it, as a therapist, as a healer, a 15-year private practice. I ended within 3 weeks, and I gathered a group of people, my best students at that point, in a room, and we sat here. We simply sat in the room and I said, okay, Saqqara, Temple of Healing, whatever you are, please come. You know, please be with us and show us what you're about.
Right.
And what occurred was something that was so life-changing for me that I literally did give up everything and just took this on as my life purpose, because I had been looking for my life purpose and feeling that I had come to the planet for a very, very powerful mission, but I didn't know what that was.
Uh-huh.
And until I found that, I truly was in deep agony, looking, searching for that mission, and asking, looking at other people who appeared to have their mission.
Right.
And I kept saying, if you have your mission, you know, where's mine? Where's my purpose? Knowing that each one of us has come for a very powerful purpose, whatever it is.
Especially at this particular time.
Specifically at this time, because we're all being given the opportunity to find our full enlightened nature, our full God-conscious nature, our full loving nature, you know, whichever words you want to put to it. So what happened that day changed my life forever. And what occurred was that energy forms began to come into the room that everybody could see. It wasn't just that I could look clairvoyantly, which I could, and see a very large pyramid descending in the room. I could see a Star of David, a three-dimensional star tetrahedron that was in gold. I could see angels' wings coming in. I could see the Buddha coming into the room. I could see Yeshua, who later got named Jesus by the Romans. I could see him coming into the room.
The room wasn't getting crowded, though. It all seemed to fit, right?
It was full. It was very, very full of energy.
Right.
And they all showed up, and people began to spontaneously go through profound changes. They would burst into tears, or some people would go into very, very deep and still inner places. Other people would just start, their bodies would start to have spontaneous movements, or they'd go through profound emotion.
If you say spontaneous one more, I'm going to have to say spontaneously combusted. I held off at two, but if you do it once more.
I've used it twice already, huh? Okay, poke me if I do it a third time.
I'm going to have to say someone spontaneously combusted, and we've never seen him again.
Okay.
No, go ahead.
So, as these energies came into the room, we unspontaneously
combusted.
Right?
I promise you, I do it. Beyond the
you didn't say about oh.
No, the yard was close enough.
Oh, Alan, you didn't. You didn't warn me.
It wasn't really fair.
But well, we'll talk later about this.
Okay. Oh God, with all the energies you can bring into a room.
Okay. So. What occurred then is that people truly began to experience a deep transformation. And I came to recognize that this was the work that I was here to do. So what I do at this point is I travel.
How long ago was that?
This was about 4 years
ago. An hour and a half.
It just came to me.
Just sitting here. Year and a half?
No, 4 years.
4 years.
4 years ago.
Uh-huh. And so since then you've just been like making Sakara available to as many people as you can, and your whole workshops and...
Right. I do workshops. I go into different communities and hold an event. And what I do is an introduction where people come and they can really get to experience the energies profoundly. And then if they're interested, they can come back and do more. And the thing, what I say to people is just, this is the gift that I have to offer. If it helps you in any way, please, please take it. If it doesn't help,
so
then don't.
You're going to be able to do like a balancing or a healing tonight. You're going to do it on a single person. And if we have enough time, you're going to be able to do it. Hopefully for the audience out in audience land, wherever you are.
Yes, and what I'd actually like to do is be able to share the energies with the people in this studio audience and also at home so that people can begin to feel some of that. And I've often had people say that when they sit in the energies, they often feel different things, like they feel heat going through their body, or they feel tremendous tingling, or they get a sense of coolness, or their whole body starts to vibrate. They experience different physical sensations. They also sometimes experience emotions occurring. And the other thing is sometimes people don't feel anything occurring as it's happening, but they report that the next day they noticed a tremendous difference, that something had shifted in their lives, or something had cleared up, or something had changed for them that they couldn't attribute to anything but the experience they had just gone through. And other people are very, very aware of the experience as it's occurring. So perhaps some people in the audience here tonight, in the studio audience, can describe for us what they're experiencing as we go through the healing. The
awakening. Do you want to do it on one person, or would you?
Yes, I'd do it on one person to start with.
And then we'll do it.
Then we'll do it as a
group. Okay, so maybe we have. Yeah, we have a really beautiful clip. We had a lot of calls the week she was on, and a lot of calls since then of Abigail. She was that 17-year-old singer. So I think what we'll do is show a clip now, and Anamika will get set up to do the healing. So as soon as the clip's ready, let's see. It's a beautiful clip. Here's Abigail.
You don't have to know it to understand the ways. Music is the handbook to guide you through the maze. So do not judge the cover, just read between the lines, and you'll get a feeling that easily defines the maze of ways. Through my life I've always known that I've always belonged to this person I'm wearing. Yet that doesn't mean I can't frolic outside of this body my mind is sharing. This person is not my home. to express things. Words are so hard to understand when they are spoken. Stop speaking, start feeling.
You all like that. Now we'll have Anamika do a healing on Gabrielle, so just be real quiet and just pay attention. I think it should be very powerful. So take it away.
Hi.
Hi.
And I've never worked on Gabrielle before, and we've just met. So what I wanted, and is it okay if I do hands-on with you?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, great. So what I'm going to do is begin to explain what's happening as we go along as I'm doing the healing, but I'd like you to start with just telling us what it is that you'd like some help with.
Well, I'd like some help with feeling less fatigued and more energetic and like I have a direction. I'm not sure a lot where I'm going, so if I could feel a little more directed and maybe coming from my heart more.
Okay. So, great, thanks. So the first thing that I begin to do is to scan her energy field or her aura to see with my hands, and I've already located a place, I find where it is that she's blocking herself from being all that she can be. And what I'm finding is some fear here. You know that one?
Yeah, I feel that.
You feel that right now? Yeah. Okay, so what I'm going to do is assist her to move through the fear so that she can get an experience of herself without that fear. And once she gets that experience in her body, she can then take that home and be with that and work with that, okay? So I'm going to move some energy around so that it can help you start to crack open, and you let us know what's happening as we go.
Right.
Okay, so I'll be silent for a minute now as I'm moving this energy. And I'm going to be breathing deeply. I'm actually starting to crack open an energy block that's been there for her for quite a while that stopped her from being all that she can be. Mm-hmm, that's good. There we go. And this energy block is starting to move. I'm using my hands to move this. And I'm putting energy into her body. And it's not my own personal energy, it's coming energy that's coming through me from the universe into her. And what are you experiencing, Gabrielle, as we're going?
Well, I feel some big pulses of energy just kind of moving kind of through me down.
Good, that's right. Great. And I'm starting to open up this shell of fear that's been around you so that you can breathe a little more deeply and feel freer in yourself so you don't have to be constricted anymore and bound up in this fear. Good. And if you notice, her breathing's starting to change. She's beginning to breathe more deeply and draw in some real nice breaths. And I'm starting to move with the energy down around her legs, too, because the particular energy form that I saw was all around her body. It wasn't just in one location. It was an entire shell of fear that's been holding you back. That's good. I feel it starting to lift off and lighten up. It's coming off her legs now. Good, you're doing great. She's really, really taking in the energy very deeply. And she's also allowing this whole shell of energy to be moved off of her. There we go. Great. It's coming off very, very nicely. And I'm just assisting it with my hands to actually come off. Good. And I'm going to start to work on her back a little bit and take the energy, that shell also, start to crack that open and move it off. Good. Your body feels like it wants to move. Yeah, just let it move. That's right. And she's actually helping this process, and she's not doing these movements purposely. They're occurring. There we go. Great. And it's really starting to crack open very nicely.
I feel kind of like I'm expanding, like a balloon blowing up a little.
Yes, you are. Your aura is starting to come out very big and wide as you're filling yourself in with who you really are, and we're taking the fear out and filling you in with love, with yourself, with the spirit that you are. Good. Yeah, it makes you want to really, really be big, huh?
Yeah.
Good. And if you notice her skin tones are changing and her facial expression is starting to change as well. Good. You're doing great. Okay. And this is not a painful process at all. It's actually, it can feel very wonderful. Sometimes people go through some very deep emotion and experience some pain coming up, but the energy moving itself is not painful at all. And as she releases this particular shell of fear that's been around her, this one will not come back. There may be another layer that actually surfaces to be moved at some other time. And that's the process of life. We go through the peaks and the valleys where as you release one layer, then the next layer comes up and you feel better for a while and then the next piece will come. But this particular layer that she's released is gone now at this point. This one will not be back. This one it's done. So yeah, this is just a little sample of a healing, but why don't you tell us how you're feeling and what you're experiencing at this point?
Well, everything seems brighter. I feel like I can just see clearer or something. And I feel kind of hot and much more relaxed when I first got up here.
Yeah.
Much more.
So you notice that the fear is actually, you're not in the same fear that you were in before. It has shifted. Yeah, and you actually, to me, you look a lot calmer. You look much more open. Your eyes look brighter and clearer. Your skin tones have changed. And you're breathing now. Before, you were very frozen up and constricted.
Yeah.
Did you feel that? And now your body is actually moving. So what happens is that the movement begins to come in, and there's aliveness that happens. So you're more alive now than you were before, more awake, more alive, more aware. Great. Good. Okay. Just going to complete this. And I'm just completing sealing off her aura and completing the little piece of work that we did. And it actually moves very rapidly. When one is working with energy, I noticed that as I started to work with energy, it began to move much more rapidly than when I worked only with the psychotherapy. And I didn't discard the psychotherapy. I use everything that I've ever learned. But including the energy makes everything go much more deeply and rapidly. How's that doing now?
It's good.
Good. Feeling pretty good?
Yeah, it's good.
Okay. Hey, she's pretty loose. Great. Thanks. I want to really thank you very much. It's a courageous thing to sit in front of an audience and do that, so I really want to thank you very much for that.
Thank you.
Yeah,
thank you.
Great. Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm. So at this point, we can do a healing on the audience, or did you have something?
Well, you know what we'll do? I think what we'll try to do is we have another clip that people have requested, and we'll do that, and then we'll get everybody set up for that, and then you could do a healing on the studio audience out in TV land and the studio audience in the studio, which we have a lot of people here tonight. So this clip is a very beautiful clip. It's speaking of opening, this is it was sent to us by David. It's a flower opening. I think that we might have shown it before or part of it, but it's just really, it's one of my favorite clips. I think it's really, for tonight, it's a perfect kind of clip because it really gives you that experience of expansiveness and openness and just coming alive. And as soon as we can cue it up and get it ready, and then we'll have everybody in the studio audience, or some of the people, set up on the for Anamika to do a healing on them, and hopefully we can do it in a way that that the you in the studio audience can experience it. So this clip is is an interesting one because it's a little bit longer than we usually do at this time. But I think it's ready to go, so watch it, and I hope you enjoy it as much as I do. So whenever it's ready. You like the clip as much as I did. Also, we're going to turn it over to Anamika to do the healing, and she'll go out for the whole show so she can just finish out the show. But I want to say, if anybody has any questions about anything or any comments, from now on you have to write the case, you know, write care of me or care of Bridging Heaven and Earth to KCTV 414 East Carrillo in Santa Barbara, and we'll respond to all the comments and letters we get. So at this point, if I don't see you again, good night, and I hope Wistancia is feeling better and with us next week, and for the rest of the show, Anamika, hopefully you'll have a wonderful experience for us. So, Anamika.
Thanks, Alan. Okay. What I'm going to do is work with the studio audience and also work with those of you who are at home at the same time. So make sure that you're in a very comfortable position, and if you're at home, just uncross your legs. If you're interested in going through this healing, you don't need to participate, but if you are interested in participating, just get your feet on the floor. You can have sit cross-legged, but just don't scrunch your body up like that. And let's just begin with taking a few deep breaths together, just so that we can get relaxed. And what I'd like you to do is to think about what in your life you would like to let go of, and what you would like to have changed. So if you have any fear that you're holding on to, or if you have any old pain or any grief, or it can be something physical, it can be emotional, it can be something that you would like to embrace in your life, like you would like to know more of what your life purpose is, or you would like to know more about what your gifts are, or there's more of yourself that you'd like to discover, or you'd like to be more creative, or you'd like to be more of who you are. Anything that you'd like to let go of and anything that you'd like to embrace. So I'll just give you a minute to focus on that and come up with an answer inside yourself. Good. And as you're focusing on that, what I'm going to do is invoke or call in or invite in the energies of Sakara. And you will begin to sense, you may begin to sense these energies coming in. And you may begin to sense some changes going on in your body. You may begin to sense some emotional changes or some changes happening in your being. And I'm going to use my hands to hold these energies and to continue to bring them in strongly. And I ask you to breathe deeply. You can close your eyes if you're comfortable that way, or you can keep them open. And continue to breathe very deeply. And if your body begins to move, just allow that to happen. It's okay if you notice some movements happening. And breathe again. And within yourself now, ask for help from Spirit. Ask for help from Spirit, from your guides, from Source, from whatever it is within you. And you don't have to believe in any of this for this to work. I actually grew up as an atheist and never believed in any of this, but what occurred for me is that I came to know the presence of God very deeply in my life. I began to experience that entwinement within me. And I came to know that, but it wasn't from a belief. So it really doesn't matter if you believe or not that you can change or you believe in Spirit, but simply open yourself. Have a willingness. It has to do with the willingness to be open to allowing for the change. So if you're willing, ask within yourself, say something like, okay, Spirit, please come and assist me with this. I'm open to being helped. I would like your assistance. I would like your help. Good. That's good. Okay. And you may feel that the energy is actually deepening within you now and getting even a little bit heavier. It's getting more intense and more grounded. And what's going to happen right now is that anything that you've asked to let go of is going to start to be pulled right now. It's going to be pulled out of your body, right? So allow yourself to release and to let go of whatever it is that needs to be let go of. And this doesn't have to be difficult. You'll notice it will just begin to get pulled out of your body. And if you don't feel anything as this is happening or you don't see anything, that's okay. Just stay with whatever it is you are experiencing. You may sense just a feeling of peace or relaxation at this point. And don't be concerned if you're feeling it or not. Simply allow it to happen. At this point, it's starting to get pulled out more and more. And now what's occurring is that there's something starting to fill in the places that were taken away. Whatever the darkness is or the wounding or the fear that was taken out is starting to get filled in with a higher frequency. It's a frequency that's love. So allow this new frequency to come in. It's beginning to come in from the top, coming down from the crown, and it's going to start to wash over you like a waterfall. And it's filling in the spaces in your body where the old was taken, and it's bringing in something new. So with that, We bring many, many blessings to each of you. Allow the blessings to come in. Allow them to be received. You're beginning to be showered with much love and much many blessings. And that energy is coming down very gently. Gently infusing you, gently coming in. And allow yourself to feel filled, filled with the love of spirit, filled with the love of source. And that love is deep within you. Blessings to all.